everybody. It's Jenny from the Missouri Star Quilt Company, and I am here today with Shannon's cuddle expert.
That's me.
Teresa Coates. And we are so happy she's here, and we're going to teach you some things about cuddle. Mm-hmm. Maybe you've never heard them before. Maybe today's your first time sewing with cuddle.
It's a great time to start.
If it is, it's a great time to start. So what do we have today, Teresa?
We are working on a little cuddle scarf. It's like a little magnetic hold.
So
very sweet.
You're not as old as me, but when you get to be my age, if your neck is warm, it is everything.
Yeah.
And so I love this because it's got the little magnet right here.
Mm-hmm.
And it just like, it's not like you have to figure out what to do with all your scarf tails.
And, when you're done, you can just tuck it away into your purse or whatever, too.
I love this. This is super cool.
I really like it, too.
All right.
I think it's fun. So we're going to work on this, which is, we're going to do it out of a yard of fabric, which means you can actually make, what do we figure out?
Six
of them. Yeah. A bunch of them. So it's a great project for that.
Great gift as well.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Exactly.
We're going to show you how to put in a magnet.
Mm-hmm.
So look at they liked each other.
They like each other.
So tell me what we need to sew with cuddle.
Okay, so the first thing we're going to need is obviously some cuddle.
Yeah.
And the kind we've got today is a luxe cuddle, which is lovely and the fluffy stuff. You also want to make sure that you've got a 90/14 stretch.
So tell me, do you have any idea, like, how many different flavors of cuddle?
Oh, it's like 1,600. It's crazy.
It's a bunch, right?
It's crazy, yeah. So if, like, people are like, oh, I don't know, I want this one, I want that one. I'm like, stores can't necessarily have all of them. I think you might have
most of them. I think we have the most assortment
there are
of anybody
ton.
In the whole world. Yeah, there's
And there's so many different colors of all the different varieties.
Really,
yeah.
Everything. And
it's
different textures and different lengths.
Yep. Yep, exactly.
So
this is one of the luxe ones. So the luxe are anything that's more than 10 millimeters long.
Okay.
So they go from 10 to actually 35 millimeters. So there's some that are like really fluffy.
I mean, they have everything from the cheetah to the bright solids, everything.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Exactly. So we're gonna want cuddle, so you can choose whatever you want. I mean, this project will actually work with any of them. It'll be beautiful.
I know. I have another one that's like a little, one of these that's like a little, it looks like, well, it looks like a fur, you know, like a regular fur you'd buy.
Yeah, you'd totally make it
so
very
cool.
Luscious.
Yes.
So we always want to make sure that we have stretch needles. So we've got a 90/14 stretch needle. And we want to do
And
a
why
stretch
do we
needle.
Need that?
Because it's a knit fabric.
Okay, that makes
so
sense.
So we want to use a needle that isn't as pointy, basically, mm-hmm. so it'll kind of slide through the fabric, and it won't actually pierce the fabric. So it's just different. We want to make sure we have that stretch needle and polyester thread.
Can I ask, though, if I only had a regular needle, I could probably still do it?
You could probably still do it. The thing that happens is you get skip stitches.
Oh, okay.
So that's the problem.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
You know,
so if you have
thought something was wrong with my bobbin.
Yeah. No.
It's the needle.
It's
Very
the needle.
Good to know. Good to
yeah.
know.
So if you're getting those skip stitches, and the problem with that is that it kind of weakens the mm-hmm. seam. So getting the right needle from the beginning is good.
And then
thread? Polyester thread. And we use polyester thread because it's polyester fabric. And it's a knit fabric, so it stretches.
Oh,
and polyester
cool.
thread stretches just a little bit, too.
Okay,
so you're
as
not
quilters,
gonna...
we mostly use cotton. But again, it could snap the stitch. Or...
It snaps. Yeah, that's what happens is the seam will break. And then
Makes
you have
sense.
To go in there and hand sew that closed again.
Nobody wants to do it.
Mm-mm. No.
Nope.
No.
Mm-mm. All right.
So you don't want to do it. So that's all we really need for this project.
And we have these little magnets.
Yep.
Little tomato magnets. And we are going to, they're like hidden. Like
yes.
You would never know there's magnet
no.
here. Look at that secret magnet. Yeah, I love it.
It's our little secret.
That's right. So it won't fall off your neck.
All right.
So what are we going to do?
So let's cut this out. We're going to do that first. So let's move these over here.
I'll be your Vanna.
Okay. And then we're just going to cut this. So this should be a yard of fabric, if I remember right. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut it. We're going to have a hard time seeing it, the black on the with the camera, but we're going to draw the lines first. And this is what I always do with cuddle. One, because it's kind of slick on the back. So when we put the ruler on there, it wants to move.
Mm-hmm.
So if I draw it out first, it's a little bit easier.
And cuddle comes like 60 wide, too.
It's 60 inches wide.
And there's also 90, right?
Yes. Okay. Yes, for quilt backings.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is great.
Which I use a lot. I love
Me
it on quilt
too.
Backs.
It is
so
beautiful.
So many people are texture people, and they love how soft this is.
Oh, it's lovely. And yeah, and there's so many different textures. So you can get like the smooth ones and then the, you know, a little bit crazier ones. All right, so 28 inches, I believe, is what we're doing.
I'm not sure.
I don't know. Let's make it up.
Yeah.
All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my rulers together. So it's going to be 9 inches by 28. We should probably verify.
I can look.
So we've got
Keep
6.
Going. I can look. Yep. 9-inch strip.
Okay.
The length of the fabric.
Right.
Or as many 9-inch strips as you would like scarves.
Exactly.
You
keep
can just
on
keep going.
Keep on doing it. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 inches, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to do 9 inches.
And honestly, this, you could modify this.
Totally.
You know, if you were making this for a giraffe, you'd want it to be much wider than 90 because it would have to cover a really tall neck, right?
Yeah, totally. You could wrap it around and around and then come back.
That's right.
Okay. All right. So we got down to
24. Giraffes need scarves. Who knows?
That's right. All right. So now we're going to add another 4 inches.
Now, wait, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, up to the top.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, okay.
Sorry, I'm doing my ruler stuff.
You're doing clever ruler work right there. I would have moved them both up. Move my.
I am lazy in some ways. I'm just going to try to move as little as possible.
I consider myself a lazy sewer as well. And I think people appreciate that. You know,
I think so. I've had students who tell me I'm not lazy. I'm efficient.
Efficient. I like that.
Sounds much better.
It does.
I like
sound
that.
Much better.
I still call myself a lazy one. All right. So we're going to go ahead and cut it. I marked it on all the sides. If you were going to do a bunch of these, I would just mark them all out and then just cut it all up.
And so, I'm actually wondering, you know, is this wide enough to do a whole nother one the other direction?
You could.
It is pretty close, yeah.
The thing is that with Cuddle, if you do it this way, the nap and the stretch. So this way is the stretchy way. This way doesn't stretch.
Okay.
So it'll be easier to sew these lengthwise because it doesn't stretch at all.
Okay, perfect.
So you could do it the other way, but it'll lay
a
little
different. That is good to know.
Okay.
Because when you put Cuddle on the back of a quilt, it matters which way you set it.
It does.
You know.
Yep, exactly.
I mean, that's what I know about is the quilt stuff.
Yep, so and most of the stuff when we're making with Cuddle, we really do try to, like, in our patterns and when I'm teaching stuff, I try to make a point about which way the stretch goes because it does make
and
a
so
difference.
And so again, so this one, no stretch
lengthwise
of your scarf.
Exactly. So we're going to go ahead and cut it out. So one of the things about Cuddle is that it's kind of messy, mm-hmm. right? So if you cut it with a rotary cutter, what happens is you cut all this nap. Mm-hmm. And it gets really fluffy, but I can cut it with scissors and it's much better.
Yeah.
So I've got my Karen K. Buckley scissors here, which I love. And I love this size because
everybody loves those scissors.
They're so good.
Yeah.
But I love them because the blade is really small, but the handles are really comfortable. So I'm just going to slide it right underneath the backing fabric.
So she's actually sliding in between the fur and the backing. And
so, and what it does is it leaves all that on there.
Not so much of the fur will come off.
I'm just going to.
And it's interesting, you know, that they're so tiny, but they do the job.
They're mighty, but they're efficient.
Mighty and efficient.
Yeah.
There we go.
They're mighty little scissors. I really do love these guys. Okay. All right. So now I'm just going to cut down this whole thing.
Alrighty.
And I've left the. Yeah. If you get it right, you can let it slide for a while.
There we go. I'm just almost speechless.
It's pretty great.
I do cut fabric like this all the time, but I didn't know it was a thing with Cuddle.
You can only do it. So I'll say you can only do it lengthwise.
Is it like children don't try this at home?
Right. So practice it a few times and then you'll get better. And like you can see, it won't slide the whole time and that's fine. Okay. We're just going to come across and cut here. It won't work widthwise. So, and I'm sure it has to do with the way that it's knitted, but they don't teach me how to do that part.
There you go.
It's above my pay grade or something.
We don't worry about the
I'm not going to worry about the salvage.
Because it's
fine.
You can't tell.
You can't tell, exactly. So unless it's going to show and it looks kind of ugly, then I will take it off. But otherwise, I just leave it there. So now we've got most of our nap on here. Mm-hmm. So that's the thing is when you cut this with a rotary cutter, all of this ends up everywhere.
Yes, yes.
Not as much fun. So we're going to gently take that away.
Mm-hmm. Gently.
Gently.
I want to wrap up in it. You know that.
I know. So then what I do is I take this and I give it a little flick.
Yeah.
I get rid of most of the stuff.
Well, some people will use like a vacuum. Like one of those.
I use a little hand
vac.
We use a shop vac at the studio. Yep. Exactly. So now we've got our little piece. Okay. We're going to go ahead and we're going to put in our magnets.
Oh, perfect.
First to get that started.
Okay. Let's open these up. Let's see what we got here. So there's two.
Mm-hmm.
And
we're going
to
put them.
Take them out of the plastic, or just the plastic?
We're going to leave the plastic on there, and we're going to sew the plastic onto the actual fabric.
All right. That's good to know because I would have, you know.
She says we can do it. Sally Tomato does, so we're going to do it. I'm going to trust her. So we're going to put this in 2 inches from either
like
side.
This.
Plop it down there. Okay.
Does it matter which way?
I don't.
Well, we have.
Oh, there it did.
These are very strong.
Okay.
I love that. All right, this is going to work.
Okay, so we'll check this one first, and then we'll put that one in and make sure that they match.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm thinking, now I don't know if this is going to pin. Oh, it did kind of pin. Let's see if I can do it.
Maybe we can just move it over to the sewing machine.
Maybe.
hold it. I'm not a big pinner.
I love pins.
Well, pins with Cuddle. I take it back. With Cuddle, yeah, I gotta use pins.
I do love my pins. All right, so we're gonna sew this on just very careful. Oh, there it is. It's stuck. There we go. Ah, this will be fun.
I think it's the pin that might be.
No, it's the magnet.
Oh, the magnet. Okay. Do we want to slide this card under there to see if this helps
it? See if we can give it a shot.
I
got the needle down, there we so go. All it right. might.
Maybe that will help.
Oh, that might help. All right. All right, so we're going to try to stitch this down here.
Okay.
I've bumped this stitch length up, so I made it to a 3.5 because I always sew bigger with Cuddle, okay, because it'll move through a little bit easier that way. So let's see if we can get this to move. There we go. Come on. Why is it just doing one little step at a time? Oh, there we go. It's because I don't know what I'm doing yet. It's not my machine.
Now, the really cool thing about Cuddle, honestly, is that you really won't be able to see this stitching on the outside.
No, exactly. Yeah, we're going to turn this over and you won't see it at all.
Also, it looks like there's a little bit more plastic room here on the sides, and you could even just like corner it too.
You probably could. Yeah, you kind of tack it down a little bit. We're just going to stitch it around. It's going fine.
It is going
I think
fine.
That little card you put under there was a smart idea.
There we go. How do you put innovation. In a magnet? With a credit card.
Don't do it with a credit card.
It was just the package.
Yeah, exactly. Just slid it right under. It worked out fine.
Sally Tomato didn't know what she was doing with that package, but it's worked really well.
Now, if we found that I've quilted package
there we go.
to the scarf,
oh, yeah,
I'm going to laugh.
Could be happening.
We don't know.
Could be happening.
But we'll cut it out if we are.
That's right.
There's worse things. I've sewn other things to my scarves.
I actually do a lot of handwork, and I one time sewed something to the leg of my pants.
Oh, jeez.
That was hilarious. I was laughing so hard.
That's hilarious.
It's ridiculous.
All right. So we're going to take our needle up. Is there a little scissors?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Oh, it's so stuck to the machine. That's hilarious. All right, let's see. I did. I totally sewed it to it.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Here we go. Let's cut that baby out. And you know what? You'll never be able to tell as long as I don't cut the stitches.
No, and knowing now that we know, we would probably move this every corner or something.
Probably, or you know what you could do is maybe use a tearaway stabilizer.
Oh, that'd be good too.
Your finger's not behind me, is it?
No. I actually love that this worked so we can show everybody how to do this.
And that it happens even to the pros, right?
Well, this was our first time, to be
honest. That's right. That is true.
We have never tried the paper underneath. But it's easier than trying to tug a magnet.
It is, because it hangs on real tight. I mean, it even wants to grab my scissors.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So my scissors are like, hey, I like it here.
That's right.
Like, stop, go away.
All right. Perfect.
All right, we're going to pull that out later with my little stiletto, and it'll be totally fine. Okay. I may not even need to. You probably will never notice at all. All right. So now we're going to try it on with the other side.
And so it's not
because now we
corners.
Need two magnets.
Okay.
Right. Well, it's two corners of the same thing here.
I'm thinking these like two corners. No, but
it's this corner, right? Okay. So that they'll kind of wrap around in.
All right.
So if we do that, if it comes around,
all right, I'm going to take this out of the plastic this time and just do the card because I think if we have to cut it away, that might
be easier. So I just want to see if it'll stick this way.
Right.
Or does it stick better? Oh, it sticks really good that way. Okay. All right. So let's try it again. We're just going to measure in. So I'm just going to use my ruler again to measure in 2 inches and 2 inches and stick this baby down.
Okay.
Okay, so in the same place that it was before.
Do you want to pin it or do you want me to draw a line around it?
Draw a line around it. There That'll help. That's a good idea.
There we go. All right, so we've got our little square drawn here.
Right, for where the magnet needs to go.
Yes, and we do need to make sure because this doesn't stick together this way. It overlaps.
Right,
so we need
to
make sure when we turn this, let's turn it around and let's look at, this is our sewn-in one. Mm-hmm. So we'll pull this down.
Go that way?
You know, because it's going to stick together
this
way.
Exactly, yep, come around
our
neck.
Come around here and we'll make sure that
it grabbed.
Yes.
It totally worked.
It totally works. So do check that out when you're placing your magnet. Make sure that it works that way.
Exactly. And that was a great idea with the drawing the square around it first because then it's easy to come back and put it exactly where it's supposed to be.
We just
much better.
Brilliant minds work great together,
so
don't
good.
We?
All right, let's give it a try. See what happens.
You're
I'm going to try it this time without anything underneath
without
just for
anything.
A second just to see what
just
happens.
To see.
Cause see how strong that is?
It
so
is very
interesting.
Strong.
Okay, want to see, ooh, it might not work. We might have to put that paper under because
we'll
it really wants to move. Okay, so I just did a little, back stitch, and I'm just gonna try to get my way across here.
Are you having to push it very hard?
I am. I'm not really pushing it. I'm just kind of keeping my hand on this so that I can make sure it keeps moving, because it would like to just stay there, and I don't want it to.
Do you think it's the walking foot that's moving this through so nicely?
I think the walking foot helps a lot, sure, because it has those little grippies on the bottom that's grabbing both the fabric and the plastic.
Now, I have one of those machines where you can adjust the presser foot.
It's my favorite.
Do you want it to be
lighter?
Oh, lighter.
Less pressure.
Oh, okay. I would have thought the opposite. So that's good to know, too, for all of you who have one of those.
Exactly. And it really does make a difference, because what it does is it allows the fabric to kind of work itself through much easier without getting any fight back from the
machine. And what I do love about doing a project like on a little machine like this is that it just shows anybody can do this.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Exactly.
Anybody can do this.
You just got to take your time. You'll all be good. All right. So let's do that. Okay, now it's stuck. We'll take it out.
And then we don't have to trim anything off the front either.
No.
So it's nice to know
it did
that
work.
Worked.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's nice to know that works.
That's great. So I think having a stabilizer under... It's hilarious.
Let me hold it down.
This might be a two-person job, just right this part here.
Cutting, trimming the threads.
Yeah, so if you've got the little scissors thing on your machine, that's a great way of dealing with
that. Yes.
Use it right now.
All right.
All right.
So here we are with our two magnets.
So now we're done. No, just kidding. All right. So now we want to create actually like a little tube.
Okay.
That's going to be how we're going to finish this off. So one of the things that I like to do when I'm working with Cuddle fabrics is I like to, when I have a turning gap, mm-hmm, is I like to do a stay stitching line.
Okay.
So we're going to do that first, and we're going to stick a little line here in the middle. I basically do the width of my hand, which happens to be 4 inches.
Oh, I never measured my hand.
I only do because I do it like this a lot.
I'm also 4 inches. I believe we
Look
are twins.
That. I think we are. These hand twins.
Mine are much older.
And mine have more rings.
As pretty.
So what I did is I just marked my 4 inches, uh-huh, on either side there. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do a stitching line on either one of these. I'll show you when we get to the end why it's actually really, really helpful.
Yeah, I've never actually thought about this. This is really interesting.
So this works very well with Cuddle. And we're going to do it with about a 3/8 inch seam allowance. One of the things about Cuddle, too, is seam allowance is a little, mm-hmm, variable.
A little bit.
And so we're going to do just a stitch right along here, one layer.
All right, so now that you're doing this, tell me about stay stitching. What is actually stay stitching?
Well, stay stitching is used a lot in apparel sewing, mm-hmm, for giving you some stability in seams. I use it here to actually give me kind of a guideline on where my seam is going to go. So it's not really for stability, but just more for seeing it. I'll show you when
you sew the rest of it. This is your guide?
No, when I sew the turning gap closed.
Oh, when you sew it closed. Okay, that
makes
sense.
Yeah, so when I have to sew it closed, now I've got a line in it that'll show me exactly where I need to turn it. So the cool thing about this is that I have this little stitching line in here, and I can just flip it really easily.
You just know exactly where it goes. Okay.
So it will turn really easily on that stitching line.
That sounds great.
Okay?
All right.
So that's what we've got there. So now we've got the stay stitching basically on both sides. They should match up for the most part. We're going to go ahead.
Ish.
Ish.
Yeah, I love the ish.
Okay. So what I like to do is I pin a corner, and I pin the other corner.
I think you should let me pin something because my whole audience doesn't know I pin.
Oh, you can. You know how to use pins?
I do know how to use pins.
Oh, well, look at this. Let's do it. Let's do it. Okay, so I'll give you a couple pins.
All right, so tell me what we're going
to
do here.
What I like to do is I'm going to put a pin here at the end, and then we're going to put pins in actually this way.
Oh.
So I pin parallel to the raw edge.
Because
it holds down more of the fabric and kind of lets me keep it nice and flat. Something like this, because we're sewing the length of the fabric, it isn't going to stretch too much. But if it's getting too much stretch, I do this thing called double pinning, where I actually do two rows. So you don't like pinning. I love pins.
Well, you sew with an entirely different type of fabric than I do.
It's true.
So now I have actually, we have this little, will this matter? So the other thing I'm noticing is that because I'm left-handed, I'm pinning the opposite direction that you do.
Okay, so I'm right-handed, so I pin further away from me this way.
So
I'll show you. Yeah.
Shall I just go ahead and turn these?
Yep, but what you can do if you're left-handed, take your pins out and I'll show you a trick.
Okay. A trick.
Okay.
All right.
So if you're a lefty, you do it this way and pin closer to you.
Oh, look at that.
So I'll let you pin the rest of those back
there
in there.
There we go, right?
Yep, so if you're right-handed, you pin further away. If you're left-handed, pin closer.
Okay.
Yep, and then you're gonna pin it the right direction because basically we wanna pin it so that the pins will come out as we're sewing. They don't have to take them out too
right.
early because that's super frustrating when you have to take the pins out way before you've gotten
yeah,
there.
Yeah, and all of a sudden I noticed, I'm like, wait a minute, hers yep. are different than mine.
So one of the things I mentioned is I like to pin the corners and then I'll pin any place that has to match first.
Okay.
So I stuck this pin in and then you redid this and mm-hmm. it matched.
Okay.
So I kind of do that with Cuddle to kind of get
Do we
it to
need
work.
A double row?
We don't really need a double row with this one because it's not so stretchy because
okay.
it's lengthwise.
All right.
So if I were doing a big widthwise seam, I would do double row.
Do we need pins on this part?
I am. I'm going to throw one in there. Throw one in there at the end. Okay. And then we're just going to sew this seam. And then I'm going to do a little funky thing here that I call an L pivot in all of our patterns. We're going to sew off the edge.
Oh, very
show
cool.
you how to do that.
I do that on my right. bindings.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It works very, very well.
I everybody's like, why? I'm like, I'm not sure. Just seems like a cool thing to do.
It is cool, but it also gives more stability to
yeah.
it. So I really like
oh,
it.
Oh, now I have an answer. So
okay.
good.
More stability. All right. So I'm going to still use a bigger stitch length. So I'm using a 3-point, excuse me. I'm just going to use a bigger stitch length, a 3.5 millimeter stitch length. And that's because Cuddle doesn't come through my machine as fast.
Okay.
So if I use a bigger stitch length, it'll be a little bit more normal. And I'm going to go ahead and back stitch first because we want that seam to hold. And I'm just using the edge of my walking foot there as the guide. I think it's probably about 3/8, and it really doesn't matter too much.
No, I think on a project like this, consistency is more important than
yes,
perfection.
Exactly. And Cuddle is super
yeah,
forgiving
gonna,
for lots of
I'm gonna
lots
grab
of these.
These as they come off.
Go for it.
And so you don't end up with the whole pile. Well, I have
Thanks.
To have a job to do. You know.
I appreciate
Something
it.
To make myself
so
useful.
It stretched a little bit here at the end, so I've got a little flap, but I'm gonna try to keep it at a 90-degree angle right there at the corner.
Okay.
So that's why I just let it be big. Oops, sorry. Here you go. And I'm just gonna let that ease through here. I like this. I could use an assistant in my
right?
studio all the time. It's fabulous.
The pin person, that would be me.
Yeah, thank you.
Do you know, I do a lot of things with Natalie and Misty, and it's so helpful when you're like, can you iron this?
Yes,
can
exactly.
you just do this? It is helpful.
Perfect. And so as I'm sewing this, you might see I have my hand back here too, mm-hmm. that I'm trying to just keep it nice and flat. So we really want to, if it starts to build up a little bit, we want to kind of conquer that. And a lot of times that is
the
changing the
way.
Presser foot pressure,
sure.
readjusting things, kind of, you know, giving it a little pucker if you need to, because it's Cuddle, it will be
now
fine.
Now you're going to... Now right here is where our stay stitching is.
Yep, so I got to the stay stitching, and then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna pivot, and I'm gonna sew off the edge.
The L pivot.
That's the L pivot. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and take that out, and then I will, there we go, cut my thread, come back, and then I'm gonna start in here and go the other direction. I'm gonna use that little lift thing. That is seriously, I think, the best invention with modern sewing machines. Is that extra lift?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, it comes in so handy. Okay, pivot again, and then I'm gonna sew the rest of the way. Just super easy.
You're right, it's so
I'm
hard.
Not, it's...
You're automatic to
I have,
toss.
I have a, yeah, a method to my madness, and it's usually just a big pile of pins over
well,
here.
Well, it's because you do it by yourself, right?
It's true. I don't usually have an assistant taking my pins for me, but I could get used to this.
Right?
I really could. Okay, and again, it pushed just a little bit, but not too much, so I'm just going to let it be and come off this side. Take a bigger seam allowance. It's fine. It's fine. Okay, we'll even it up.
Well, to me, the part that I was most interested, worried about is not this, it's the magnets.
Yeah.
And those went pretty smooth.
Those went fine.
Those
I was kind of wondering
yeah.
if it would cause an issue. Okay, so now we've gotten it to this point,
okay.
we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna leave these corners in here for just a mm-hmm. minute. We'll turn it, we'll see if it makes a difference. One of the things with Cuddle is it often doesn't make any difference if you have extra bulk in the corner.
Yeah, I have I turn a lot of Cuddle and I've never noticed.
Yeah, I generally don't trim them. So it's kind of a nice thing because the less cutting, the less mess. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and turn that.
And take a look at it.
See how it is.
Look how pretty it is.
It's gorgeous already.
Boom. Right?
See, look at that.
That's perfect.
I can't tell that there's anything weird about that. And I love this because, do we want to top stitch it? Oh. I'm like, could we? Should we?
I wouldn't. This one is, though. I don't think you need to.
I don't know that you need to.
But
I feel like it would be just fine. Okay, this might be where you need a big, like a knitting needle or something to shove these corners out.
A wooden spoon.
A wooden spoon. That's a good idea.
Because I don't want it to poke through. But it's, there you go.
And my little stiletto. That works out. Nice. So there we can see a little bit of our stitching on here. So you can see this. So you can go back in here and you can fluff up these edges. And nobody will ever know that it was sewn.
How will they know? They'll never know.
They'll never know. Perfect. All right. So then we've got our little turning gap that's here. So we can go ahead and you could hand sew that. So you see how it just turns in super nicely? So this is my favorite part of it.
This would actually be a reason to top stitch it because you could catch the whole thing.
You could, but we can also just zigzag that edge.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And it won't show.
Yeah. Wow. It won't show too much. So I generally, if I'm going to gift it to someone, I'll hand sew
it. What's happening here?
We'll just catch everything. So it's your tool catcher
now. Right.
So I could go ahead and hand sew this if I were going to give it to someone. I would want it to be really finished super nicely. For myself, I'll zigzag it. So we'll do that and see how it turns out.
Right.
Okay.
All right, let's do it.
All right, can I have a couple of pins? I'm going to keep this in
place. Yes, you can.
Thanks. I do like my pins. So, and I'm just going to pin these this direction so I can kind of keep it where I want it to be. So basically, I'm matching up those stitching lines so that I can see. It's going to work out just fine, I think.
The stay stitch idea is really cool. I'm intrigued by that because I used to be an apparel sewer. And so many things changed. So, like, I took apart a quilt that I made, like, before I really even realized I was quilting. It was just a denim quilt. And all the seams are 5/8.
Yes.
Yes. You know, I'm like, wow, I can get a whole bunch more room out of this.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Block now that I'm sewing at 1/4 inch.
Where all of a sudden, it can be so much bigger. All right, so now we're just going to zigzag this closed. I've set the zigzag to a 3.5 by 3.5. So you can kind of do whatever, 2.5, 2.5, 3, 3. I just usually keep it square. It's really my
that's
MO. Yeah, it's just easier to remember that way for me. Usually 3.5 is kind of my go-to for this sort of thing. So I'm just going to stitch right along this edge. And basically, you can't, I don't know if you can see it, Jenny, but the needle is coming just off the edge of the fabric. Kind of we want to have it be so it ends up in the middle of the, it'll look like it's not catching because there's so much fur. So we try to like hide it in there a little. It works pretty well. I'll show you. So a lot of times people
want
to stitch it over there.
Perfect.
Yeah.
You can't even see it.
I have practice.
I've done this a few times.
So let me go ahead. I'm going to trim my threads. There's another couple good ones.
That's really a good hack.
So then it makes it just quick and easy. And if I come back in here again, I can just fluff things on seams like this. This is also where I like to take. You can take a pin or a stiletto and just fluff this
up. Oh, my gosh. Look at that.
And it just makes it look all finished and beautiful.
You'd never know there was a seam there.
No, exactly. And then it looks so professional and fancy.
Well, do we have a name for this little guy? What are we calling him?
There's got to be a name somewhere.
Cuddle
it's
scarf.
It's just a cuddle scarf.
Cuddle scarf.
So I'm just going to do it because this is my like little neurotic thing that I like to do. You know, some people like to bind quilts. Mm-hmm. They really love that part. I kind of really love the fluffing part. But I'm like, oh, look, but it's so nice now.
It's so pretty. Well, I feel like we should each put one of these on.
I think so.
All right, let's do it. Here we go. Oh, my neck's so nice and warm.
It's lovely.
I love it. Well, thanks for being here today.
Yeah,
this was awesome.
Absolutely. This was great.
We learned so many good tips, and we hope you enjoyed this tutorial on the magnetic cuddle scarf from the Missouri Star Quilt Company. Hi, everybody. It's Jenny from the Missouri Star Quilt Company. We hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you aren't already part of the Missouri Star Quilt Company family, be sure to subscribe so you won't miss a thing. And if you click that bell, it'll notify you every time a new tutorial comes out. See you next Friday.